Hello, my name is Steve Harbin. Today we begin a brand new series called How to Thrive at 85. And we have a subtitle, Overcoming the Grasshopper Mentality. Now our leadership dynamic is realize your God is a lot bigger than your difficulties. And that is so true. So much of the time we make God so small and our problems so big, when we ought to tell our problems how big our God is. We have a passage of scripture that shows us a dialogue between Joshua and Caleb that actually reveals how big Caleb's God is. Now look at this. It says, the descendants of Judah approached Joshua at Gilgal and Caleb and said to him, you know the Lord promised Moses, the man of God at Kadesh Barnea, about you and me. I was 40 years old when Moses, the Lord's servant, sent me from Kadesh. Now, it's important, let's note, he was 40 years old. He was not a young man then, but he's really not a young man now. And so he was 40 years old when Moses, the Lord's servant, sent him from Kadesh Barnea to scout the land. And he said, I brought back an honest report. My brothers, who went with me, caused the people's hearts to melt with fear. But I remained loyal to the Lord my God. On that day, Moses promised me, the land where you have set foot will be an inheritance for you and your descendants forevermore, because you have remained loyal to the Lord your God. As you see, the Lord has kept me alive these 45 years, as he promised. Since the Lord spoke this word to Moses while Israel was journeying in the wilderness, here I am today, 85 years old. I am still as strong today as I was the day Moses sent me out. My strength for battle and for daily tasks now as it was then. Now give me this land. Give me this hill country. The Lord promised me on that day, because you heard then that the Anakim are there as well as the large fortified cities. Perhaps the Lord will be with me and I will drive them out of the land as the Lord promised. Then Joshua blessed Caleb and gave him Hebron as an inheritance. You know, every Christian has the opportunity to leap from the ordinary to the extraordinary. However, many are very mundane in their leadership skills and development and training. They're like a giant ship in a small pond. Now just imagine this with me. You see a giant ship and he's in a pond. And when you see a ship in a pond, you know there's no way for that ship to turn. There's no far port for that ship to sail to. There's no future at all. And that's what's happened to a lot of our people. They have gotten older, they have gotten bigger, they've gotten fatter, so to speak, and they loom as large before the people as anybody could be. And they've been in church a long time, and their influence has grown immensely, yet they have not grown in years. They have so much potential. You can actually see the possibilities in them. Yet they are stuck in this pond. There's no vision, no dreams, no port in which to travel. They're simply a ship in a pond. You can see the potential in them, however, they cannot see it. They think that since they have risen to a level of leadership by position, that's all there is. There's no need to go anywhere else. But what if we can change the leadership scenario? What if we can develop them into gigantic leaders who love God and love His church? What if we can get them to look into the future and see what God has for them and the church? What if we showed them how they can thrive at 85? Not literally 85, but in their senior years. How many people have you got in your church that are over the age of 55? These people are called senior citizens. But they're more than that. They are seniors in the kingdom of God, who have and can have great leadership abilities and can move the church from a basic level to a gigantic movement of God. You say, but they don't do anything. Well, that may be true, but maybe they're doing nothing because you let them sit and soak. They have no great opportunity to lead and are given no responsibilities according to their giftedness. So much of the time, we will approach them and ask them to do small, insignificant things, but don't put them in a place according to their giftedness. You say, but how do I know what their gifts are? That's easy. You ask them. If you can get this force of people working for the kingdom of God instead of occupying a seat in your services, you would have a mighty army moving forward in God's work. Lead them to let their senior years to be their productive years. And Caleb's a great example of this. You see, Caleb serves as a good example of three important qualities. You see, if your people are to thrive at 85, I believe your people, regardless of age, possess these three qualities in their spiritual walk. And others who can develop these qualities as a given purpose to move beyond where they are to where God wants them to be. The first of these qualities is persistence. Caleb was promised a piece of land 45 years earlier. Now just think, he never stopped thinking about that land. Moses promised him the hill country. Now he was 40 years old with all kinds of ideas on how to accomplish what God had promised. Now it's 45 years later, and he held on to that promise. It was as if his dream and vision were real to him, even for the future. Moses instilled that in him. He believed that even at 85, he could take it and make it what God wanted it to become. I want to show you a leadership principle. And with this, I'll close until next week. Look at this leadership principle. When God gives you a promise, never release it. And that's a promise you can bank on. Until next week, this is Steve Harbin.